Today I'm going to be doing the beach review at Key Biscayne Beach, and this beach is located inside Bilbag State Park. So you do have to pay to get in here because this is a Florida state park, but I was at this beach once before a few years ago, and I just had to come back and do this beach next for you because I remember I loved it here, and after being here for just a little while, I remember why I wanted to come back. So let's get right into it. First things first. In order to get here, you have to cross a causeway. You have to cross a toll bridge, and it's all automatic. You don't have to stop and pay the toll. They either bill you by the plate, or you have to have the Sun Pass here in Florida. And if you have just a regular car, it's $2.25 with the Sun Pass, and it's $3 if you just get the toll by plate. The next thing is, once you arrive here, you have to pay again to get inside the park. All Florida state parks you have to pay to get into. None of them are free. This one costs $8 admission per vehicle. The good thing is though, once you come here and you pay to get into the park, you don't have to pay for parking anymore once you're here. And you know, the last beach I was at, I ended up spending actually more on parking than it cost to get into this park for the day, so that's pretty cool. So let's start off with the things to do at this beach, because the list is pretty lengthy actually. So here they have a lighthouse, which you can see in my footage here, and it's not open right now, probably because of the virus, but prior to now, the lighthouse is open, it's free to get in, and you can literally walk to the top of it, and the view up there is pretty spectacular, and there's a lot of history at this beach and this park. And that's the other thing to note, this beach is in a state park, so there's a lot of stuff to do here besides just the beach. As far as the beach itself goes, there are no rentals as far as jet ski rentals or parasailing, things like that. But they do have some other type of fun things to do. They do have bicycle rentals and kayak rentals, and they also offer beach umbrella service. You can also come here and spend half the day at the beach and then spend the other half the day fishing, as they do have a fishing area just south of the beach. And they also have plenty of hiking and biking trails everywhere around this entire park. So there is no boardwalk here, but they do have plenty of trails, so you can really come here and do a variety of activities all in one day. This beach is pet friendly, but according to the notice that I saw, it seems like it's only pet friendly in certain areas. But the tricky thing about that is it doesn't say which areas of the beach are pet friendly and which ones aren't. But that brings me directly into the next point, the rules of the beach. They don't seem to have a ton of rules here, just the ones I'm showing you now. They didn't have like a long list of rules, kind of like Dania Beach did. And as far as I can tell, there's nobody here actually enforcing any of the rules they do have. I see some guys on four-wheelers, but those guys are all just in charge of putting up the umbrella and the chair service for everyone. And since it is a Florida state park, they do have park rangers, but I don't see them patrolling the beach or anything like that. Another important thing to mention is there are no lifeguards here, and they plainly state that right when you first come into the park. So you really got to swim at your own risk here, and it is a pretty expansive beach. And if you're bringing your kids here on a beach day, you'd really want to keep an eye on them, because it's easy for them to get lost here. There's dunes here with very tall grass, and a kid could easily disappear in there, and there are wild animals here. And the good thing is the water itself is actually very shallow, so you don't have to worry about drowning so much, but you still got to keep an eye on your kids if you're coming here with your family, no doubt. There's no lifeguard who's going to do it for you. The type of people and the culture at the beach. The culture here seems to be predominantly Spanish. That's the main language I hear being spoken here. Although in this section where I'm at right here, I'm at the more northern end of the beach where it's a little less crowded than down by the lighthouse. And I hear more English and there's more families up here. So if you're looking for a more quiet beach experience, I would stay on the north end of this beach. But if you want to be in the madness, I would say stay closer to the lighthouse then. So it is pretty crowded here if you go down by the lighthouse, especially for a Monday afternoon. I actually wasn't expecting it to be as crowded as it is. But it's not too bad. If you come in the northern end, like I said, we're able to get away and not be in the mix and be around a million people, which I hate doing that at the beach. Doesn't matter what beach I'm at. So I like finding a nice little secluded spot for us to just come and relax. And you kind of get both vibes here. So if you want to be in the mix and be around the party people, you can have that. And if you just want to come and have a nice quiet time and enjoy the weather, you can have that too. The cleanliness of the sand and the water. I have to say this is a very clean beach. I don't see much trash at all in the sand. The quality of the sand here is a lot finer and a lot more powdery than the sand at Dania Beach. That beach had a lot more coarse sand and it was actually a lot rougher to walk through. If it wasn't so hot at the beach today, the sand would actually feel quite nice to walk through. But the heat level of the sand makes it pretty much unbearable to walk through barefoot. But the actual texture of the sand is very fine and powdery. The water is crystal clear today and it's very shallow. And one thing to note about the water is that it's a lot different than Miami Beach, even though this isn't very far away. The water here is very shallow and you would probably have to walk out quite a ways to actually make the water deep enough where it's gonna go over your head. And some people might like that, but the reason why I don't like it is because it makes the water a lot warmer. It's literally like bath water out there. I prefer when the water is a little bit cooler and deeper, so that way you can really cool off more when you get in the water, because today it's like 100 degrees as it usually is on most Florida summer days. So the cooler the water, the better in my opinion. But some people, if you like the bath water, then you're really gonna love this beach here, that's for sure. And another thing to note about the sand, the immediate thing I noticed when I first got here, guys, and I started taking footage out at the beach, is this sand was extremely hot. Even though I was wearing flip-flops, it's still extremely hot and you can still burn your feet very easily. So I would suggest coming with a pair of shoes or a better type of slipper or something like that, more than just flip-flops, if you're gonna be walking in the sand a lot, because it's so hot that you can literally burn the bottom of your foot and get like a first degree burn and have some blistering. So you don't want that to happen. Be prepared to have a decent shoe to walk on the beach. Don't be like me and just bring the sandals and burn the hell out of your foot. There is umbrella and chair service here. I don't remember the exact price because I'm not looking at the footage that I took, but I know for sure it's offered here and you guys can see the price right here in my video. Public restrooms and showers are pretty much at the entrance of every part of the beach here, which is pretty great because obviously that's a necessity. It would be exactly what you would expect for a state park, because obviously if you're gonna pay to get in, they should have some premium amenities like that. And even though that's not something really asking for a lot, having public restrooms and showers, you'd be surprised how many beaches actually don't have that. Parking was free and it's very easy to find. There is plenty of parking here and there is handicap parking. One thing to note about the handicap parking is that while it is the closest parking to the pathways out to the beach, the path to actually get from the parking lot out to the beach is pretty long. So if walking is an issue for you, it's going to be still tough. You're gonna wanna have some kind of beach wheelchair or something like that if you need to utilize the handicap parking, because it is a bit of a walk from the parking lot to the actual sand in the water. There is also one restaurant right over here by the beach, and there's also another restaurant on the other side of the park, which is not really close to the beach. So I would say that you're just gonna have the one restaurant here for food options, and that's pretty much it. It's kind of like Dania Beach in the sense that you wanna bring your own cooler and your own food, because even just leaving the beach to go to that restaurant is kind of a pain. You gotta walk all the way back over that way. You gotta sit and you gotta order, and it's gonna take a while. And it's kind of inconvenient. So when you come to a beach like this, I would suggest just bringing all of your own gear. You know, bring your own food, your own water, your own chairs, your own umbrella, so you don't have to pay for that stuff either. But if you just want to have the maximum level of convenience, of course you could just come, rent the chair and umbrella, and go to the restaurant and not have to bring anything besides your wallet. A good point that somebody asked about in the last video is, can you get here via public transportation? I did see a bus stop, but it was about, I would say, a quarter mile to a half a mile away from the park entrance. So it is possible to get here with the Miami-Dade transit system with a bus, but you're gonna have quite a bit of a walk to get to the beach from that spot. And if you're carrying like your beach chairs and your umbrella and all of that stuff, it's gonna be pretty inconvenient. and I wouldn't recommend getting here that way. The best way to get here would be to just drive in the car with a group of friends, or you can even bike here because there is a biking path that comes straight into the park. But one thing to note, no matter how you get here, you do have to pay to get in. They charge for pedestrians, they charge for bicyclists, and they charge for cars. So no matter which way you're entering the park, you do have to pay. But it works itself out and makes it all even because you don't have to pay for parking here. Now, what do I think about this beach? Well, this beach is pretty nice. I like that it has a variety of areas to be at the beach, and like I said before, where you can kind of escape the crowd if you want to. It's a very low-key vibe here overall. There is a lot of families, there's a lot of couples, and I like having the natural dunes like you see right behind me, right here by the beach. The whole thing is so beautiful, and even if you just want to walk around the park and see everything there is to offer here, there's a lot of wildlife here. You see wild raccoons and squirrels running around everywhere. I've seen spiders, I've seen butterflies, and the whole place is just extremely beautiful. It's not just the beach that really draws you to this place, it's the whole experience. You could really come here and spend a whole day doing all sorts of things, you know, doing the beach, doing the kayaking, doing the fishing, exploring the White House, I keep saying White House, exploring the lighthouse, and also just going around the trails and going for a nature walk, or bringing your bicycle and riding the bike around the trails. There's just so much beauty to absorb here that I would highly recommend it here. This beach here at Key Biscayne definitely gets high marks in my book, especially as a beach veteran living on the beach now for over 12 years. If you've never been here, you should definitely come and check it out at least once. I have nothing bad to say about this beach. And guys, if you liked this video and you really liked hanging out with me, I have really good news. I have plenty more where that came from and many more videos for you to check out right over here. And I'll see you guys over there in that next video.